wife and I lived for 9 years on our own boat and cruised over 60,000 miles. And when we were doing that, we thinking, well, we can't do this forever. And we need to find a place to move ashore, spend the rest of our lives there. And we were doing this while we were tied up at a slip in downtown Hampton, visiting a friend that we'd known from the Cleveland area. We belonged to the St. Mel Yacht Club up there. And we had known he had moved here to Newport News originally, and then eventually went to Hampton. We went in there and went ashore and called his number. Conversation was something like, where are you? He said, where we were, and where are you? He said, well, if you turn around, you could probably see me. Turned out we were very close to right in front of his house where he lived. Eventually, we moved there, and there was a place available, the condominiums right there, downtown Hampton. And so we were always interested in boats. We like to do volunteer kinds of things in the community. And we had met some people who were volunteering here at the Mariners Museum. And we got to be friends with them. And they said, well, you ought to come over and volunteer at the museum. Your background, your knowledge, that sort of thing. It sounded like a good idea to me. And I was particularly interested at that time in building boats. They built boats here at that time. I like doing that sort of thing. I've done some of that myself, small boats. But when I walked into the shed over there and smelled fiberglass, I decided I didn't want to do anything like that because I like working on wood. I think maybe I told you about the book that's Ellen Lyon, the Surgeon General. Yeah. That was the most intellectually challenging thing I ever did. I thought, but now, today, I'm doing one on warship, British Navy, 1835. And it's extremely difficult to read. But I also did some early years, did some dose-sitting myself, if there's such a word. These are people that particularly Monitor Center needed a lot of people, and I helped with that. There have been other things, but those are things. Then most recently, and this is where you found me, you saw some of those things over the table and so forth. I am, well, start over on that. When the museum was first created in 1932. It was a depression and nobody had any money except Mr. Huntington and Mr. Ferguson and some people like that. And they sent these buyers all over the world, gave them carte blanche. They just go buy these things. And they did, and so it all got accumulated, got here. And there were letters exchanged and bills paid and invoices and all that sort of thing. The two, unfortunately, did end up together. So we have artifacts here that you didn't know where they came from. And letters and talking about things you didn't know where the things went. So what I've been doing most recently is going through all those boxes of correspondence. And connecting them to the artifacts that are here. And I think I've told you that what you've seen is but about 5% of what the museum has in terms of artifacts. And so I'm trying to prove where these things came from and document when you saw the files there that now has all that information in them. I'll never live long.